This is part 4 of Angular CLI tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to customize command prompt vendor. You might be wondering, why are we talking about customizing command prompt vendor in an Angular CLI course? As we know, Angular CLI is a command line tool. We run it using the command prompt vendor. So if we know how to customize the command prompt vendor to suit our needs, then we will have better experience using the Angular CLI. If you already know how to customize the command prompt vendor, then you may skip this video. Now, as far as Angular CLI is concerned, I think the most useful command is this command, ng --help. This is going to produce the list of all commands and their associated options. Notice when I hit enter, it's going to produce quite a bit of help text on the screen. And as we scroll up within the command window, notice we are not able to see all the commands and their associated options. Before this ng generate command, we are not able to see what other commands we have. And to fix this, all we have to do is increase the buffer size. To increase the screen buffer size, we just need to increase the height property value under screen buffer section on the layout tab in the properties window. To get to the properties window, right click on the title bar of the command prompt and then select properties from the context menu. And then click on the layout tab. Notice here we have screen buffer size section. To increase the screen buffer size, all we have to do is increase the height here, and I'm going to set it to 4 9s, and then click OK. This increases the screen buffer size. Now let's scroll down a bit and then clear the screen, and then issue the same command ng --help, and then hit enter. It's going to again produce the list of all commands and their associated options that we can use with Angular CLI. Now notice as we scroll up, we can see all the commands, including the command that we have typed, ng --help. As you can see, with Angular CLI, we can use many commands. Now if you want to find a specific command within this list, you can use the command prompt search feature. To access the search feature, all you have to do is right click on the title bar once again, edit, and then select find. This brings up the find window. Within the find window, type what you're looking for. I want to look for ng generate command, and I hit find next. Here we have the ng generate command and all the associated options as well. Another way to get command specific help is by using that flag --help with that specific command. For example, if we want to get help associated with ng generate command, then we type ng generate command and then use the --help flag on that. So I type ng generate and then --help. Now when we hit enter, it's only going to produce help specific to this ng generate command, as you can see right here. Sometimes you may want to redirect and copy the output of a command to Windows clipboard instead of displaying it on the screen. For that, we use clip command. Let's look at this in action. Now, when we use this command, ng --help, we know it's going to produce quite a bit of help text. Now, I don't want that help text to be displayed on this command prompt screen. Instead, I want that to be redirected and copied to Windows clipboard. To do that, we use the pipe symbol and then use this command, clip. Now when I hit enter, it's not going to display the help text on the screen. Instead, it is copied to Windows clipboard. Now we can open any of our favorite program, maybe Notepad, Word document, etc., and then paste all the help text that is copied to the clipboard. And later, I can print this out if required. We can also redirect the output of a command directly to a Notepad or a Word document. Let's look at this in action. Now what I want to do is redirect the output of this command directly to a Notepad. To do that, we type the command ng --help, use greater than symbol, and then the name of your document. Now I'm going to call this help.txt. And notice we are executing this command within C drive. So a file called help.txt will be created within your C drive, and the output of this command, ng--help, will be placed in that file. So let's hit enter. So command completed. Now let's go to C drive, and here we find help.txt. And when I open that, we can see the output of the command copied to this text file. Along the same lines, if you want to redirect the output to a Word document instead, you simply change the extension to .doc, press Enter, it's going to place the help text within the Word document. So now when we go to C drive, notice we have help.doc as well, and when we open that, we have all the output there. While we are here, let me also tell you another quick tip. To cycle through the commands that we have used so far, we can use the up and down arrow keys on our keyboard. So notice it is cycling through the commands that we have used. From the properties window, we can also change cursor size, font size, etc. Let's quickly look at that in action. To get to the properties window, we right click on the title bar and then select properties from the context menu. On the first tab right here, we can change the cursor size. We also have several other settings here. On the second tab, we can change the font size. And on the third tab, we have seen how to change the screen buffer size. We can also change the window size and window position. And on this last tab, we can change the font color and background color. You can always play with these settings and see the effects they have. In our next video, we'll discuss all the options that we can use with Angular CLI's ng new command. Thank you for listening and have a great day.